Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Those who are new on my channel, my name is Cynthia, and in this video I want to show you step by step on how to set your trading view account. And again, I'm going to show you simple strategy that is beginner friendly, and anybody who has been trading, you can also use this simple strategy. You only need two things, and I'm going to show you the two things that you need while setting your trading view account. It's so simple and very short. It doesn't make too much noise on your screen. So simple. So this is something that I've shared on my screen some days ago, and if you've been following my videos, I hope you've watched the video. So and today again I want to share some, okay, the video is not going to be that different, but I'm just going to use the same indicators that I used when recording that video. And again, I'm also going to apply the same strategy, but I'm just going to say maybe some things that I didn't say in that video. So be keen while watching this video, and make sure you watch until the end of this video for you to understand all the steps that I'm going to take you through, guys. So before I get started, guys, if this is the first time you're watching my video or you've come across my channel, consider subscribing, because you know, guys, when you subscribe to my channel, it's a favor you're doing to me. At the same time, it's a way of appreciating my work, because I'm sharing this same strategy without even charging, because some people are charging $100 just to show you this simple thing. But for me, Cynthia, I'm not going to charge anybody anything. I'm just sharing with my fans free of charge on my channel. So the only thing you can do for me is liking the video if you love the information in it, and also subscribing to my channel. You can also share with your friends who are interested in learning how to trade the simple ways. And guys, I'm sharing something which is 100% sure, something with 100% win, like 100% win rate, like you're going to win with this strategy. You are going to lose nothing. And again, remember, I'm using this strategy to trade spot. Those who said that you cannot make 100 as your profit today, you can even make $500, even 1,000. So it depends with the money or the capital you've started with, or maybe let me say the money you are trading with. So this strategy is so simple. It's very simple. Even by watching, if you are new, you've never done trading before, if you're interested and watch this video until the end, you're going to learn a lot, and you're going to realize that you've been wasting your time reading too much, following. Okay, you know, sometimes you read to get the basic knowledge, because you know there are some things that you learn but you can't apply them. You just learn to know to have the knowledge. So with this one, I'm not going to take you around the bush. I'm just going to take you direct to what you're supposed to know and to do, what you're supposed to do while trading. So how you're going to trade, the strategy you're going to use, this is what I'm sharing on my screen. So you can also download the video so that you can watch later, or even save the link of the video so that you can remind yourself every time if you're a beginner, you haven't traded before. And this is something you cannot just listen to it for the first time and just be like that. You can listen to it, set your trading view account, then re-listen to it again as many times as you want. So for those who are new in trading and you want to start but you don't know how to start or where to start with, so the first thing you need trading view account. If you want to create trading view account, the first step, just go to your browser. Those who are using laptop, just go on your browser, then search for trading view, then trading view, then tap on it, search for it, then you'll see something like this. Go for the first result. For the first result, you can see trading view, track all markets. So go for this one. When you go for it, tap on create account. Let me just show you. Tap on create account. So for me, I have mine. But as for you, because you are just a beginner, you have no trading view account, you need to create one. So the first thing you need to do is to create trading view account. After trade, you will see something here, create or sign up. You'll see sign up stroke login. So because you are new, you don't have any account, you'll just go for sign up. So when you tap on sign up somewhere here, you'll get it somewhere here. You can't see it on my screen because already I have an account. So when you first tap on that create sign up, it will give you spaces where you're supposed to fill in your details, or the simplest way is by signing up using your Google account. So easy. So after that, you'll be able to log into your account because now you've created it. Then you'll have to set your trading view account the way I want you to. The way I'm going to show you. So as for mine, let me go. Okay, this is where I was. As for mine, it's all set. I'm just using two indicators, which I'm about to show you. So you only need two indicators on your screen to know when to get out and when to enter in the market. Only two. We are avoiding too much noise on our screens. So make sure you follow what I'm doing on my screen, guys. So the next step, I'm going to show you how to set your trading view page. So I'm going to show you. The first thing you need to know is to set the time frame you're going to use. So with this strategy, use 4 hours. So I know you're asking yourself, where am I going to get the hours or the time frame? So when you tap on the 4 hours or the hour that you're going to get on your screen for the first time, we have 1 minute and many of them. We have up to 12 months. So with this strategy, we are just going to use 4 hours. You can also mark it, mark the stars so that it can be under your favorite. So I'm using 4 hours time frame with this strategy. And the next thing you need to do is to set your candle bars. Your candle bars. So okay, bar styles. Let me say bar styles. So this is where you're going to get your bar styles. You tap on it, it will show you all the candle styles that we have here. We have many of them, but for this strategy, we are going to use the simple candles. You can also mark the star so that it can be under your favorite, because you'll be using it each and every time you want to trade. And the next thing, you're going to set indicators. So for now, let me just skip this part of indicators because I need to explain more about indicators, because this is where we are going to get the two indicators I was talking about. So let me skip it for now, then go for the alert. Okay, alert, you can maybe sometimes you are waiting for a specific coin. For example, let me use this one, is WorldCoin. You're waiting for this WorldCoin or maybe any other coin. I'm just giving an example with WorldCoin because this is what I have on my screen. So if you want to set an alarm, maybe you want the coin to reach a specific point for you to you bought the coin here and you've set your take profit limit. So you will put an alarm here at 3.9818, so that when the market reaches there, or the market reaches there, you'll be able to get notification and get in the market and sell your coin. So this is what you do with that. You set an alert, or it's like alarm. And again, you can replay here. Again, this is, you can undo the scroll right here. And the next thing, this one is no need. Okay, there's no need. You just auto save, just put it the way mine is. Then after that, we have this quick search. You also have settings, chat settings, and we have full screen. If you want to see everything fully, you just go for full screen mode. Then here you can take screenshot of what you have on your screen. Here you can publish, like sharing your ideas with the trade community. If you like, you can share your ideas. Yeah, the next thing is this one, watch list. So guys, pay attention, these ones are so important. So the next thing we have is watch list. Watch list is whereby you put your favorite coins that you'd like to sell each and every time. Like you'll be checking on them on their markets, how they are going. So this is where you add them, watch list. So watch list, okay, you can see watch list, it entails details and news. So if I tap on my watch list at the moment, you can see what I have, and I've given it my name. So with your watch list, you can name your watch list how you want. Like you can give it your name, your pet name, your mother's name, your daddy's, like you can just put any name you want. So as for me, there is my name, and you can see the coins that I've put and as my favorite coins or on my watch list. So you can see the coins that I have right here, you can see. And I don't know whether you guys have realized something with my watch list, that the coins which are in my watch list are coins below $5 and below, coins with $5 and below. You can see this, that is $5, I think that is okay. I have even six. So you can see the I have coins with small prices. You can see that on my screen. The reason why I'm doing that, or the reason why I've done that, is because you see this, when you are trading when you are trading spots or even futures, don't go for coins with big prices, because the one secret is this: when you trade these coins with small prices, you are going to make much profit compared to coins with high prices. I don't know whether somebody's getting me. So that is the reason why on my watch list I'm only using the coins with small prices. You can see, I think this is the highest fill. Yeah, this is the highest coin with the highest price on my watch list. You can even check. This one, Uni. Oh, yeah. You can see Uni has the highest. Yeah, I think 6 is the highest price on my watch list. Yeah. So when you're setting your, or when adding coins on your watch list, remember you are given specific number that you can add on your watch list according to the plan you subscribed. So as for us people who are using free or basic account, we are only given specific, we are given specific number of coins that we can add on our watch list. So I don't know how many of them do I have. I can't okay, because of time I'm not going to count all of them, but I would have counted them, but I'm not going to do that. So another thing that you need to do, guys, look at my coins on my watch list. Make sure you add these coins on your watch list too. You can see them. Let me just scroll slowly so that you can see all of them. Make sure you watch the video until the end for you to understand, because I'm still going to say something related to this. I'm just showing you the coins that you're supposed to add on your watch list, because they are so good. When you trade them, you get much profit. You can see all of them up to here. So I don't know how many coins they are, but they are okay. So normally these are the coins that I normally trade. I check on them whenever I want to enter in a market. I have to check on all of them so that I can see which market is good than the other, or which one should I enter So after that, I know you're asking yourself this question: how am I going to add the coins on my watch list? So here we go. For you to add the coins on your watch list, let me just undo one coin here. I like this OP. Okay, if you want to undo or remove a coin from your watch list, you just go on it, then you tap on X. You can see this X right here. You tap on it and the coin will be removed automatically. You can see it is no longer on my watch list. So I'm going to add it, and this is the way we do it, or we do add the coins on the watch list. So I'm going to tap on this plus symbol or add symbol on my right hand. You can see it right here. So when I tap on it, it will bring me here, and you can see my list is under crypto. So guys, I'm talking about crypto here, so make sure yours is also under crypto. You can see here mine is under crypto, so do the same on your screen. So we are going to look for that coin that I undid or I removed from my watch list. So I'm going to type the name of the coin. It was OP against Tether. So here it is. Was giving examples using this perpetual, so because I normally use both when features and sports. So okay, but for those people who want sports only, can go for this one, but for me, I normally use these ones. After that, you can see this, meaning it has been added. If you want to remove it again, you can just do the same thing right there. So I'm going to undo that, then check whether the coin has come on my watch list. You can see right here we have it now. I removed it, and now we have it on my screen. So that is it. If you want to do to undo the watch list so that you can see your full screen, you just tap on that, so it will remove it automatically. So after that, guys, let's come back to our indicators where I said I will explain more about. You can see we have it right here. So I want to introduce these two indicators that I was talking about. As you can see, this is where we are going to get them. So before I search for them, I have them on my screen. So I'm just going to undo them so that I can add them. You know why I'm doing that? I'm doing that because I want you guys to see what I'm doing step by step. I want you to do the same thing I'm doing on my screen. Because I have the indicators with me, I'm just going to reveal their names, then after that I'm going to undo them on my screen, so I won't have them anymore. And again, I'm going to add them one by one just to show you how you can add them on your screen too. So pay attention, guys. So these are the indicators that I'm using. I'm using 200 EMA to be specific. You can see EMA is in full is moving average exponential. I don't know whether I'm correct with the pronunciations, but that is it. So I'm going to undo it. That is how you can undo yours too, by just pressing on X. When you tap on it, then you do the same. So the next indicator that I'm using is higher high, lower low, live. So I'm going to undo it, then add it again to show you how you can add it on your screen too. And after that, I'm going to explain step by step what am I using them for and the reason why I add them on the screen. So just to make sure you follow the video. So I'm going to undo it as I did the other one. And now we are going to add them because we have removed all of them. So you can see our screen has got only candles. And with these candles, we are not going to know when is the right time to enter in the market and when is the the right time to get out of the market. You know why it is hard? It's okay, it's possible, yes, but it's going to be hard to identify or to know. So with these two indicators that I'm using or I'm about to add, they are going to help us and they are going to make the process so easy. So let's add them. So the first indicator we are going to add is EMA. So you know we have EMAs and different people are using different So I'm, for me to be specific, I'm using 200. Some people are using 30, some people are using 9, some people are using 100, some people 50. But with this strategy, I'm using 200. So if you're going to follow this strategy, make sure you use 200 EMA. So let's go to our indicators. So in here, if you tap on here, you'll be able to see indicators, but if you go here, you are going to get your favorite. So I'm going to show you how you can add the indicators which are your favorite under your favorites. So like mine, you can see I've ticked all of these are my favorites, but I only use two for now to avoid too much noise on my screen or to avoid too much confusion. When you are using too much indicators, you are just confusing yourself. Yeah, so just use the two and you'll be good to go. So let's go, guys. You tap on the indicators, then you'll be able to see where you're supposed to search the indicators, so long as you know the name of the indicator that you want. And for the first indicator that we are going to add on our screen is EMA, and it's going to appear on your screen. You can tap on the, or you mark, you can mark the star yellow. Also, if you want, you can remove it by tapping it again to remove it under your favorites. But for me, I have added it and it's my favorite. So you can see the name is Moving Average Exponential. I don't know how you pronounce this last word, but whichever way, so long as you're getting what I'm trying to say. So I'm going to add it and I'm going to tap on it so that it can be added on my screen. And after tapping on it, guys, you just click on this cross or X so that it can go away from your screen. So here we have our EMA. So we are going to set it from 9 to 200 and make it bigger so that it can be visible. So we are, this is how we are going to do it. So here we have it. So we are going to tap on settings. You can see the settings option here. Tap on settings. Then you'll see something like this. If you first go to settings, you'll see something like this. So the first thing you're going to do, just leave visibility the way it is. Please listen to me, leave visibility the way everything is. Go to styles. So with styles, leave EMA the way it is ticked, leave this one the way it is unticked, and leave the two the way they are ticked, and leave the default the way it is. So the only thing you are going to change here is this part, EMA part, this one right here. So here we are going to change the color and we are going to change the thickness. So for those who are okay with blue color, it depends with the mode you're using. If you're using dark mode like me, make sure your style or your EMA color is brighter so that you can see it well. And if you're using white, make sure white meaning you're using light mode. Yeah, make sure you put a color that is shouting so that you'll be able to see your EMA well. So for me, I'm going to change the blue to yellow. So you can put any color that you want. So, but as for me, I'm going to put yellow color. So this is how you get the color. So we have different colors. So you can go for the color that you want. So for me, I'm going to choose shouting yellow color right here. Mm-hmm. and remember to put the capacity 100%. You can see. Then here we go. I'm going to change this narrow or slender line. I'm going to add the thickness to the second thickness so it can be clearly seen. So you can also add to the third one or to the last one. But for me, I'm okay with the second one. I don't want it to be so big. This one is okay with me. Then the next thing you are going to go to is inputs. Very important. Guys, I hope you are following me. So here, the only thing we are going to change is length. Leave the rest the way they are. Just change length alone. So we are going to undo the 9 shade. Let me just add it. I'm sorry about that. I tapped on it and I removed it instead of. Okay, let me just add it. EMA. Okay, there we go. It is already on my screen. So let me just tap on it. Make the changes. Okay, here we go. So the first thing you're going to do is going to undo or delete the 9. Because the 9 is the what you are going to get on your screen. 9 is what you are going to get on your screen. Make sure you remove it and write 200 because we are going to use 200. And after that, I think everything is the way. Oh, I have to rechange again here. So I'm going to do the same thing that I did last that time. And visibility, I'm going to leave everything the way it is. Then I'm going to click on OK. So my EMA is well set. And that is why I'm calling it 200 EMA to be specific, because some people are using 30 and other numbers. So as for me, I'm just using 200. You can see it right here. It is written EMA 200. So I'm using 200 EMA. And the next thing you're going to set, because with this 200 EMA alone, it won't be easy for us to identify or maybe to know when to enter or to get out of the market. So we can't work with it alone. But the work of this EMA is, it will help us, or it helps us identify whether the market is up or down. So when the market is on the uptrend zone, the candles will be above 200 EMA. When the market is above 200 EMA, you can see this market was above 200 EMA. You can see it is above the yellow line. Your line can be any color. Let me just call it EMA. It was above EMA, which is 200 EMA. So we say the market was on uptrend. And when the market is below 200 EMA like this, we say the market is on downtrend. I hope you get that. So the work of this EMA is to help us identify whether the market is on the uptrend zone or downtrend zone. I hope somebody is getting that. Okay, so we are going to add our second indicator, that is higher high, lower low live indicator. So make sure you be keen and watch what I'm doing on my screen. So there we go. I'm going to tap on indicators again, then type the name of the indicator I want, though I have it right here, but because I want you to see the spelling so that you don't mistake, and you can also see the owner of the indicator. So make sure you do or copy the same thing I'm doing on my screen. So I'm going to start to type the name of the indicator, which is higher. Yeah, it's already there. Higher high. You'll see something like this. Higher. Don't go for this, please. We have many of them. Make sure you go for higher high, lower low, live by Lonesome the somebody. You can see we have different people and even the same person with another strategy. Okay, another indicator. So go for this one. I'm talking about the higher high, lower low live. So I'm going to tap on it. What did I do? I went back again to where I was. Sorry, guys. So I'm going to tap on it. So it has already been added to our screen. You can see right here we have it. So let me just go for full mode so that you can see everything on my screen. So guys, you can see what I have on my screen now. I have the two indicators that I was talking about. And the thing with this higher high, lower low indicator, please don't add anything. Just leave it the way it is. Don't go to settings. Don't set anything. Just leave everything the way they are. You get it? So that is it. So after adding these two, you are good to go. And you are now able to identify where the market is, whether on the downtrend or uptrend, when to enter in the market or to wait, when to get out or when to continue with the market. So guys, I hope you are getting whatever I'm trying to say. So the next thing we are going to, okay, I've not said why I'm adding this higher high, lower low, because I have explained the reason why I added EMA. So let me say why I'm adding this or what I'm using it for. So this higher high, lower low indicator, it helps us know whether the market is bearish. Bearish is this one. The market, when the market is going down, we say the market is bearish. When the market is going up, we say the market is bullish. Like this one, it was so bullish. This was a huge one, you can see. So this is WorldCoin. Okay, so you can see right here, with this indicator, higher high, lower low, it will identify by indicating where the market has reached so far. So for example let's use this. This was a live market and it's still live now. So this is the price of WorldCoin as I speak now. So you can see this day at this particular like moment, you can see this indicator indicated that this is the time or the moment or the price. This was the price the market went lower. Meaning, if you are waiting for the market after you saw this indicator from this indicator known as higher high, lower low, you saw this and you are like, okay, now that the indicator has showed me or indicated that this is the price that market has gone higher, let me wait for the indicator again to show me where the market has reached as it goes down. So let me wait. So you are going to wait, to be patient again, wait. Then when you see this indication from this indicator, it means that market is about to reverse and we are about to go up. Like we are about to go bullish. Like the bull are about to take over the market. You can see when the market is going down, it means the sellers or the bears has taken over the market. And when you see the market goes up, it means the bulls or the buyers has already taken over the market. I hope I'm clear. I'm not confusing anyone. If I'm confusing you, let me know on the comment section so that I can see where I am confusing you or where you don't understand. So you can see right here, if you see this, you'll have to wait again for the indicator to identify that at this point the price went lower. So if you are waiting to enter the market, you can just wait for the next candle for confirmation, then enter in the market here or the second candle. Enter in the market after doing confirmation with the first candle. Enter with this. Okay, as for me, I will enter with the first candle after seeing the the indicator. So the first one will be my confirmation candle. But some people will wait until the second and even the third so that they can enter in the market. Then set your take profit limit. Here we don't set take loss, like stop loss. So with spot trading, you only set your take profit. And it's so hard to lose money when it comes to spot trading, because spot trading only needs you to know what you are doing. So long as you know when to the right time to enter in the market and the right time to get out of the market. And it, the only thing it needs again is patience. So if you are patient enough, you have to wait. For example, right here, this coin at this time, the market, the indicator shown that here is the last price, the market went low. So we'll have to wait. So if you enter the market here, you can see right this time market was, it wasn't like, you can see the market was like, I see it's just going, coming back, going, coming back. So it was so hard to know if it will go up. So for you, you'll just enter the market here, then be patient, wait for the candles to start moving, like you can see right here. So at this point the market started moving upside. Then after entering in the market, you can also wait, you can set your take profit, then wait again for the indicator to indicate that this is the highest point, market has gone high. So you have to be patient and also be careful by waiting. So you can set your limit here and wait until the indicator is shown here. Then again, you can also take your enter in the market here, then wait until you see the indicator here, like the high or the highest point the market has gone up. So when you see something like this, be sure that the market will reach there and start reversing by going downwards. So the market will be bearish. So you can see when the market is bullish, you can see the green line. When the market is bearish, you'll see the red line going downwards. So it's so simple. For example, let me just give example with this. You can see this is live market. This is what is happening in this market, world coin market at the moment. You can see I'm using 4 hours, remember guys, 4 hours. So you can see this was Wednesday 24th. You can see even the time is in Nairobi or East Africa time, it was 15:00. That was around 3 p.m. in East Africa time. You can see market went down here. So some people, genius people, or those people who are sure, or pro traders, enter the market here. When you see this long wink, you can enter in the market as low as here, which is sometimes it's hard because it can take only 1 second for the market to go this down, then come back again here. So if you enter in a market here, you can even see this mess, the same mess you are seeing here. You can see where the way the market was behaving this time, you can see the same thing happening here again. So you don't have to get out of the market. If you bought the market, the coin here, or if you entered in the market here, you'll have to be again patient, you can see, and wait for the coin to go up until you see the indicator showing you that the market has gone up. So here, if you bought the coin here, you have to wait for this indicator to indicate that the market has gone up, or this is the farthest it has gone up, so it will start reversing. You get it, guys? It's so simple, by the way. So simple. I think that is all you need to know when trading spots. And again, for those who are trading futures, you can also do it or apply the same strategy, but when you're trading futures, you need to be extra careful. But guys, to avoid risk, to avoid stress, to avoid how do we call it, depression, you are sleeping and you are like, oh, did that trade go to liquidation? Here there is nothing like liquidation. Here there is nothing like liquidation. We are trading spots. There is no liquidation. So if you don't want stress, you don't want depression, go for spot trading. Go for spot trading. And those people who want to join exchange wallet, you can join SuperEx or Binance. You can join SuperEx or Binance. I'm going to leave the link of SuperEx app and Binance app. So join the one that you want. And SuperEx, you can join even if you are in USA. You can join and they don't charge more fee compared to, okay, compared with Binance US. They charge a lot of, like they charge too much fee. So instead of using Binance US, if you're from USA, use SuperEx. And even other people from other countries, you can also use SuperEx app. It's available worldwide. And for those who are interested and wants to do trades on Binance, it's okay. So I'm going to leave the links of the two apps on the description of the video. So guys, I've come to an end of the video. The video is too long, but I hope you're going to watch it and learn something. So my aim was to teach you step by step until the end of the video. So long as you've understood what I was trying to teach you guys, I'm so happy. No one, like, I'm so happy. So it doesn't matter whether the video is too long or not. The thing is, I wanted to teach you some things which can help you when trading. So I hope I've explained everything that I needed to explain. And you guys, you're good to go and you can start trading after watching this video. So if you watch this video until this point and you have not you've not subscribed to my channel, make sure you subscribe. You can download the video to watch later. You can share with your friends and remember to give a like. You can also turn on the bell notification so that every time I'll upload any new video, you will be the first person to watch, or even being the, not even being the first, you'll be notified every time I upload any new video. So guys, thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. For now, I have to say bye bye. Okay.